Congratulations. How does it feel to have your film shown at the London Film Festival?
It's brilliant to be at this festival. I grew up in London and went to this festival as a child, and it's always a particular buzz, and it means that, you know, my hometown people are coming to see it. I also think that London just attracts great audiences. You get film lovers, but you also get people who don't normally go to films. You get all sorts. And it's also the world premiere for this film. And it's particularly exciting for me because it began as such a tiny idea, and to show it on a big screen in Leicester Square and be part of the documentary competition is a huge buzz.
Well, you talk about the tiny idea it started with. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
So I went with my partner to Greenland. He's Danish, he'd been there a number of times, and we found this tiny little community living this precarious existence on the edge of the ice cap, threatened by all sorts of things, global warming, changing economic situations, and we follow their lives across a year and a half. We focus on a few characters who illustrate really what it's like to struggle to keep alive your traditions in the face of modern life.
When you found them, did you know you were going to make a movie? Were you looking for a film?
We were half looking for a film. I mean, we're filmmakers, so we're always half looking for a film. We can never even go on a holiday without half looking for a film. But it emerged and it evolved. We went on one research trip, then we decided to go back and try to do some filming, see if we had anything there. So it evolved. We did bit by bit, and we built it up over years, actually, 3 years.
Well, I understand social media obviously is a huge part of the film. What do we learn about social media?
Well, what you learn is that there's a teenager there who's the only 17-year-old in the town. He's never left the village in his life. Well, he's never left the region. And because of the internet, he's wearing Arsenal clothes. Actually, no, I'll take that back. He's a Chelsea supporter. No, he's not. He's a Manchester United supporter. That shows how I know my football. You'll never forgive me for that. No, but so he's someone who understands. He lives a virtual life, you know, although he's never left. So it's opened his eyes up hugely. And now he wants to go to New York. You know, the world has opened up.
And visually, the film is stunning. I mean, the location's almost like a character itself. But how important was that for you? And also, how difficult was it in terms of the seasons and things filming there?
Well, it was very difficult because you either have perpetual dark in the winter or you have perpetual light in the summer. So they're very extreme. Or you have permanent magic hour. So you have to kind of negotiate those. And also very freezing conditions, and you can't see people's faces because they're all dressed up. And the language was very difficult. So it was a real challenge on a number of different levels. But it was also liberating. We were a very small crew, so we could change our plans. We could work around things.
Fantastic. Sarah, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks very much.